Good morning, dear students. So as we started a new chapter in the yesterday's class, we started a new chapter in the human nature of matter and radiation. So in yesterday's class, we discussed the introduction of the human nature of matter and radiation and some of the definitions like electron emission. And work function and electron volt, one electron volt definition, types of electron emission. So types of electron emission, so there are three types. One is thermionic electron emission, and the second one, it is field emission, and the next and last, it is photoelectric emission. So this is what we have discussed in the last class. Okay, so electron emission is nothing but the liberation of the electrons from the metal surface is called as electron emission. Work function is the minimum energy which is required for the electron to escape from the metal surface is called as work function. One electron volt is defined as the minimum energy for electron, the minimum energy gained by the electron, which is accelerated by providing a potential difference of 1 volt. And two types of electron emission, there is thermionic electron emission is a process in which electron is emitted from the metal surface by heating the metal surface. Field emission is the process in which electron is going to be emitted from the metal surface by applying the strong electric field to the metal surface. Photoelectric emission is a process in which electron is emitted from the metal surface when some suitable frequency of incident radiation is going to be incident on the metal surface is called as photoelectric emission. So this is what we discussed in the yesterday's class. Now, in today's class, we are discussing what do you mean by photoelectric effect. So photoelectric effect is the phenomenon in which the electron is going to be emitted from the metal surface when some certain frequency of radiation is incidented on the metal surface. That phenomenon is called as photoelectric effect. Right? Okay. So the electrons which are emitted during this process is called as photoelectrons. Electrons which are emitted are called as photoelectrons, and the current which is generated during this process, in this phenomenon, that current is called as photoelectric current. Okay. So this is what the photoelectric effect is, a phenomenon in which the electrons are emitted from the metal surface when some certain frequency of radiation is incidented on the metal surface is called as photoelectric effect. Now, the next one is a very important topic. It is experimental study on photoelectric effect. Experimental study on photoelectric effect. Okay. So this explains the study of electric effect, the experimental study of on photoelectric effect. So let me draw you the diagram of this experiment. That is, as this apparatus consists of an evacuated glass tube. So this is the circuit diagram or diagram of a motor electric effect. Okay, so just I am explaining you the construction of this experiment. It is, the apparatus consists of a highly evacuated glass tube, right? It consists of a highly evacuated glass tube and a photosensitive plate. It is C, a photosensitive plate C, or it is also called as emitter plate and anode plate, or also we can call it as a collector plate, are enclosed in an evacuated glass tube. And this glass tube has an open window through which the ultraviolet light of the source is going to be incidented on the photosensitive plate. This is called as a photosensitive plate. Okay, so the ultraviolet rays coming from the source are going to be made to be incident on this photosensitive plate. Okay, now and also the polarities of the polarities of the emitter plate and the collector plate are going to be changed by using a commutator, and the potential. And the potential can be varied. The emitter plate and the collector plate's potential can be varied and is measured by using the voltmeter here. And as a result, the photoelectric current is going to be changed or it is being increased. So we can able to measure the photoelectric current by using the micro emitter. Right. So this is what the construction of a photoelectric effect experiment. Now, so this experiment is conducted to study the dependency of this photoelectric current on the first point, that is intensity of the incident radiation. And the second one is frequency of the incident radiation, and the third one is potential difference between the emitter plate and the collector plate. And the last one is nature of the material. Right. So the photoelectric effect experiment is conducted to study the dependency of the photoelectric current on the intensity of the incident radiation, frequency of the incident radiation, potential difference between the emitter plate and the collector plate, and the nature of the material of a photosensitive plate. Okay, so this is what we are going to be studying in this experiment. Okay, so to study the dependency of the photoelectric current, on intensity, frequency, potential difference, and the nature. That means how this photoelectric current is going to be dependent on the intensity, frequency, potential difference, and the nature of the material. So let me explain you one by one how this photoelectric current is going to be changed by changing the intensity, frequency, potential difference, and the nature of the material. Okay. So first of all, we'll discuss the effect of intensity. So what is the effect of intensity on the photoelectric current? This first one, effect of intensity of a incident radiation. that is how this intensity is going to be affect on the photoelectric current. Okay. So what we are doing here, we are changing the intensity here. Okay. So what happens by changing the intensity of the incident radiation here? Okay. Now, so before that, first of all, we are maintaining a high positive potential. So we are maintaining a high positive potential at anode plate. Okay. So we are maintaining a high positive potential at anode. That means at the collector plate. Okay. So we are applying a high potential, positive potential. So what happens if I do like this? So as I said that the intensity, how this intensity is going to be affect on the photoelectric effect. Okay. So how we are going to change this intensity? How can we change the intensity? So as we know that this glass tube has a open window at one side through which the ultraviolet radiations are going to be made to be fall on this photosensitive plate. Okay. So how can I change this intensity? By changing the distance between the emitter plate and the source. If I bring this source if I move this source towards the photosensitive plate, then the intensity is going to be increased because the distance is reduced here. If I move away, if I move the source away from this emitter plate, the intensity is going to be decreased because the distance is increasing here. Distance between the emitter plate and the source, if I reduce, intensity increases. Distance between the emitter plate and the source is increased, then the intensity decreases here. So I am increasing the intensity here. So that means I am bringing this source near to the, I am just moving the source towards the photosensitive plate here. Now the intensity is increased. So because of, due to this increase in the intensity, the large amount of radiations are going to be fall on this photosensitive plate. So this photosensitive plate, it receives radiations which are coming from the source. Because of, due to this receiving these radiations, it emits the more number of electrons. So more number of electrons once it is starts to emit. So as I said that I applied a high positive potential at this anode plate. So because of this high potential, these all electrons which are coming from the photosensitive plate, which are moving, which is emitted by this emitter plate, get attracted towards this current. As you know that these electrons are the negatively charged particles, and I applied a high positive potential. So positive and negative will get attracted. So that's why electrons will get attracted. Due to this, what happens here? Due to this, the photoelectric current increases. So in this, we can say that in the conclusion, I can say that here, so the number of photoelectrons emitted per second is directly proportional to the intensity of the incident radiation. Okay. So number of photoelectrons, emitted per second is directly proportional to the intensity of the incident radiation. इसका मतलब ये है, जैसे जैसे मैं इंटेंसिटी को इंक्रीज करूंगा, तब ये नंबर ऑफ फोटोइलेक्ट्रॉन्स भी एमिट होना ज्यादा होता है. सो नंबर ऑफ फोटोइलेक्ट्रॉन्स एमिटेड पर सेकंड इंक्रीजेस एज इफ आई इंक्रीज द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ द इंसिडेंट रेडिएशन. सो ड्यू टू दिस व्हाट हैपेंस हियर, द फोटोइलेक्ट्रिक करंट इंक्रीजेस. इफ आई मूव दिस सोर्स अवे फ्रॉम द एमिटर प्लेट, देन द इंटेंसिटी रिड्यूसेस हियर.
because the distance is being increased here. So intensity reduces, then less number of electrons are going to be emitted from the emitter plate, and small amount of photoelectric current is going to be generated. Okay. So hence the conclusion I can say it here. We can from this experiment we can say that here the experimental study of the experimental study of the photoelectric effect. Okay, what it says that in the first case the effect of intensity, how it is going to be affected on the photoelectric current is the as the intensity increases, photoelectrons are also increases. Okay, so this is what the effect of intensity of incident radiation which we discussed in the previous class. Okay, in the next class we'll discuss how the frequency and the potential difference is going to be affect on the photoelectric current. Okay, thank you, sir.